My name is Jennie Leikin, and we are in the NCI building, which is the National Cancer Institute. Currently, I'm working in the Laboratory for Human Carcinogenesis with Dr. Breed Ryan. And my project entails looking at two different types of lung cancer, so adeno and squamous cell carcinoma. So I am from Boston. My parents are both immigrants from Russia. They don't have a science background. My mom's a social worker and my dad's an engineer. I'm actually currently at Tufts Dental. I'm in between my third and fourth year. And I took a year to be here to learn good scientific research. And that entails asking a proper question and following through and making sure that things are working accordingly, to be able to ask the right questions and not just know things for what they are, but question it and ask why.
Talk to me about this image.
So some days I'm doing a lot of computer work, so analyzing data. Before that, I was looking at a lot of CGA data, which is, I was really interested in the bioinformatics aspect. So it was looking at small sequences and kind of laying that out and finding different depictions and an interesting story to tell. Sometimes I'm in the hood with my cells, culturing them, doing transfections. I'm using the microscope to verify that my experiment has worked. The work that I'm doing is very important here because microRNAs are crucial in the environment that cells live in. This is a way that they are able to communicate via exosomes, and it also controls more than 60% of gene expression. We're really at the beginning of this. We're looking at simply analyzing and classifying how these microRNAs look in lung cancer, and specifically I'm looking at different small variations in these microRNAs, and I think eventually we'll see certain cancers have this type of variant of microRNA. They're called isomers. And by targeting that, I think you can have more specific patient treatment because it's found, for example, that if you target microRNAs, that it can block replication of certain viruses and it can decrease tumor size.
Yeah.
And it has a lot of potential. So I think it's a very patient-centered diagnosis and patient-centered treatment, which I think is where the future of medicine is going.
I don't know, I was worried that
it's a really great collaborative process. We're able to ask each other questions, and if I have a question to my lab mate, I turn around and say, hey, do you know how to do this? And can you help me with this experiment? Or does this data look okay? What would you suggest I improve? I think what's inspirational is the fact that my curiosity led me here, and I hope that anyone's curiosity can lead them to what questions they want and what they want to do. If they so happen to enjoy computational biology, that'd be awesome. I hope that's an inspiration for them. But it's to ask questions and not always be dictated to a set path and goal or oriented thing, that life changes and throws things at you, and sometimes it's thinking outside the box. So.